It was supposed to be only just a fun night with me, with my friend, the good friend and I. I went into the theater, grabbed a seat, which ended up to be, I was sitting in the second row, probably four seats away from the right aisle where people usually enter from. Another guy walked in after me, sat in front of me in the front row, probably to the far right seat, and I noticed he got a phone call. Most people, when they get phone calls, they would take it out into the lobby, but this person directly went to the emergency exit. And on the phone the entire time, he was propping the door open with his foot, and he was it looked like he was directing somebody to come towards his direction. And I didn't think anything of it at first, but after a while, once the movie started and my friend and I got situated, about 15, 20 minutes into the film, that the back emergency door swung right open. I walked into the theater, probably 5'8", 5'9", wearing all black, and he was wearing a gas mask, all suited up in armor. It had a rifle around his neck, and he threw a canister into the audience behind him. And come to find out, once it exploded, it was a toxic gas. I wasn't too sure if it was tear gas, but either way, it was really hard to breathe in. Immediately, I went to the floor after it exploded, and then gunshots started taking place into the auditorium.
Corbin, let me interrupt you, and I hope you can hear me. I know it sounds like there's a lot of wind, a lot going on where you are, but you mentioned somebody sitting in the far right seat in the theater. The person on the phone goes to take the call at the exit door. Did they have the same build as the gunman? What are you saying? Do you think these are two different people or the same person?
I'm sorry, one more time.
So this person who you see on the phone goes to the exit door to take this phone call. The next thing you know, that this gunman comes in. Are these two different people?
If I'm making out what you're saying, yes, the person inside of the theater, yes, he went towards the emergency exit on a phone call, and it looked like he was directing somebody or looking for somebody to come to his specific location towards the back of the auditorium. And like I said, within 15 to 20 minutes, the door swung right open, and the guy came right inside, threw a gas canister into the audience, and started opening fire.
Corbin, I'm going to keep this conversation going, even though it's tough for you to hear me and vice versa, but this is so important. Do you remember what part of the movie was playing when this guy walks in, head-to-toe armor and a gas mask? Do you remember what scene was playing?
The part of the movie that it happened was after Bruce Wayne was getting robbed by Catwoman. And then the movie was still playing for probably about 10-15 minutes more. I'll say 10 minutes, and then the movie shut off, but the lights inside the auditorium were still dark. So it was kind of hard to see where the guy was or if he was still inside the auditorium, and it made things a little difficult to try to make our way out.
Did he scream anything? Was he shouting anything? Or was it all quiet? Sorry?
He didn't shout anything. He didn't say anything. He didn't make any gestures of anything. He was completely quiet.
He was completely quiet. Did you understand? I mean, did you think it was, I understand, I mean, a lot of people thought that this was, you know, just part of the shtick, part of the movie, the gas.
Correct,
obviously,
I even thought that.
Yeah, obviously you realize very quickly when you start seeing people hitting the ground that this is very, very real. How did you get out of the theater?
As soon as the gas canister went off, I immediately went to the ground and I started to crawl my way out. And as I was crawling through the second row to get to the other side, I could feel I could feel the shells of the bullets that were coming out of his rifle hitting the ground, coming up under the seats and burning me in the legs. I could feel it.
How are you now physically?
I'm doing a lot better now. I'm definitely not going to recover from this overnight. It's going to take a little time, probably somebody to talk to help me understand what just happened.
Yeah, and we just heard the news conference. They're making folks available, as this is not something you just sort of, you know, pop back from. This is a horrendous, horrendous experience for people to have to deal with. Final question. It's been 12 hours. What's the one thing that just keep, if you close your eyes, the one thing that you just keep seeing over and over and over?
The first main thing I keep seeing over and over and over is the first moment that guy walked in. The second moment I hear is just gunshots and people screaming in the audience. That's what I keep hearing over and seeing over and over again.